Hallelujah, hallelujah. Your friend and pastor, Samson Bennett Kaboko, right here at Century Life Ministries, all over Uganda. I believe the Lord is ministering to you, is encouraging you, and your life will never be the same again. I want to encourage you in scripture. This, when you remain faithful, when you remain hanging on to the Lord, when you remain standing amid this turbulent time, amid these fires, we have a God who shows up in the fire. We have a God who sends timely help. We have a God who delivers. We have a God who answers. Let me tell you, I want to continue briefly in the story of Daniel chapter 3 about these three young men, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, after being thrown into the fire for refusing to worship the golden image. The Lord sent an angel, and he came in the form of the Son of the Most High. It must have been Jesus himself. He joined them in the fire, and while in the fire, they continued to dance. They were free. And let me tell you, Nebuchadnezzar could not believe it. When he saw a fourth person, he said, "Guys, did we throw three people in the fire? I see four people in the fire, and the fourth person is like the Son of God." I want to encourage you, church, whoever is listening to me, that yes, that fire you're in, that situation you're in, that condition you're in, you're not there alone. Jesus is right there with you. He's right there with you. He's right there with you to help you. Hallelujah. And then Nebuchadnezzar called them out, and then they came out. Hallelujah. In verses 28, then Nebuchadnezzar spoke and said, "Blessed be the God of Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, who has sent his angel and delivered his servants that trusted in him, and have changed the king's word and yielded their bodies, that they may not serve nor worship any god except their God. Therefore, I make a decree that every people, nation, and language which speak the thing amiss against the God of Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego shall be cut in pieces, and their houses shall be made a dunghill, because there is no other God that can deliver after this sort." I want to tell you, ladies and gentlemen, there is no God who delivers like this God. These guys were in the fire, but the fire did not touch them. It didn't even single any of their hair. It didn't burn any of their parts. It didn't even burn their attires. They didn't even smell any smoke. Why? Because the God they served is a God who delivers, is a God who helps, is a God who understands, is the God who loves, and is the same God that we serve. He loves you, he loves me. You're not going to waste away in the fire. You're not going to waste away in all this that you hear on news. You will live, you will live, and you will serve the Lord in the name of Jesus. Your enemies, yes, they will join you in serving God. Yes, those who have sent disease, those who have sent conditions, those who have sent witchcraft, they will join you in serving this big God. May the good Lord bless you as you hang on.